Welcome to the Hydraulic Press Channel. Today we are going to press high speed camera. And the high speed camera we are going to press is Kronos 1.4. So it's the same model that we are using to make our videos. And this camera, it isn't our camera, so don't worry. It's a broken camera that David from Kron Technologies sent us. And the camera was broken when David's cat, Trixie, shrubbed this motor on top of that camera's motherboard. And now we are going to first crash the camera, and then we are going to get revenge against this. Yeah, but I think I'm going to switch the camera on. It won't like get any picture to screen or anything. It just runs it. Cooling fan with full power all the time, but I think we might get some explosion from the battery. And I still check that this says crush me and junk lens. You have to be quite sure because we have two similar cameras that we are using, and it would be quite bad to mix them up. Yeah, now everything is ready, and I'm going to switch the press on, and then we will crush this. And here we go! Whoa. What the fuck? That was pretty cool! Inside of that camera. Yeah, let's go outside. Kanni, go open the door. It smells quite bad. Yeah, so here is the end result. We took it outside because it smells quite bad. Let's have a look. Yeah, there is the touch screen. Here is the battery, that was like the main problem. And here's the probably the motherboard, and it's broken, alright. Yeah, yeah. Hey, this is funny, this is funny. Here we have 16 gigabytes of memory that are used to store the footage. And it says here that if you remove this sticker, the warranty is void. But because the sticker is still here, it's still covered under the warranty. So we are completely okay. And then the electric motor that broke that camera. And here we go. It's not looking good. It's too hard and oddly shaped. I think we're gonna crash it. It would break our press. And as you saw on the crashing high-speed camera clip, when you have two high-speed cameras, you can get two different pictures. But because our second Kronos is black and white model, it is much more sensitive to light. And that gives a couple benefits. We can go with the higher speed, we can go with the deeper focusing area, or with the shorter shutter, giving a sharper image on fast moving things. And I think it would be cool to demonstrate all of these three benefits that we can get with the more sensitive sensor. And first we are going to demonstrate the deeper depth of field, so I can use wider aperture on black and white camera, and the flying playing cards will stay sharper for longer distance with the black and white image. Or that is at least the theory, and I have been filming with the new camera like 2 days, so I'm not very good on using it yet, but I will do my best on getting good settings. And I will use same lights and same speed and same playing cards. And I'm going to run the pictures side by side so you can see the difference. Faster than I remembered, so I think I should have a bit more speed and shorter shutter time, but I think you get the point. And now we are going to demonstrate the shorter shutter time in action. We are going to crush a glass piece, and on the color camera I'm going to use quite poor 360 degree shutter, which gives a lot of light, but everything is quite soft. And then on the black and white camera, I think I can go about 180 degree shutter and get the same light or even more. So let's try that. And here we go! Demonstration speed. I have both cameras on zero gain and 2.8 aperture, and on the color one I have 2200 frames per second, and on the black and white I have 4700. So there's quite big difference. Yeah, otherwise the settings are the same. So let's crush this glass bottle and see what this looks like. I think the speed is actually the best benefit that the black and white camera gives. Other benefits are like making the picture more pretty or something like that. And I think the color picture is usually prettier on at least my stuff. But at least when you are filming outdoors without the lights, sometimes it helps a lot to get bit more light on the sensor to hit those really high speeds. And usually when you have to film like really high speed, it's just about seeing what happens somewhere. And when you are just trying to get the information, it doesn't necessarily matter what this looks like, at least on like some research projects. So yeah, the black and white camera is really good when you have to film really fast. Yeah, so here was our high-speed camera special. Huge thanks to David from Kron Technologies for supplying the Kronos high-speed cameras for us. They have been really important, especially on the Beyond the Press channel, where we use them almost on every video. And I have been really pleased with the cameras. I think they are perfect high-speed camera for YouTube channels. You can easily film close to 10,000 frames per second with resolutions that are completely fine for YouTube use. I think it isn't hugely beneficial on most cases to film with really high resolutions when most of the views are coming from mobile devices or people are watching them from small YouTube player while reading comments. And since we have been also working with really expensive Phantom cameras, we have noticed that there is only the huge price difference, but these are also really easy to use. Every time when we are filming with Phantom, we have professional camera operator using Phantom and computers and stuff like that. But with these, it's really easy. Even Anni can use these. It's just like any normal camera. You just have to know a little bit about doing your settings manually. And go check Kronos web pages to order your own camera, or go check David's own YouTube channel where there's a lot of cool high speed stuff filmed with Kronos cameras. And I had also our yesterday's Beyond the Press video on end screen where we do some oxyacetylene explosions filmed with both of these cameras. Yeah, but I think that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. For today's extra content, we have this Turkey. It has a really hard week coming, and it's really angry because of that. So it can attack and eat you at any moment. So we have to deal with it.